The Proctor, Sandy, and Utoy Creeks flow into the Chattahoochee River in Georgia. One challenge for this watershed comes from combined sewers. Like many urban creeks, they contain high levels of E. coli.
We still have areas where people still fish for bream and other things out of the creek, even though there are postings that these are still sewer outfalls. And so we still have a significant problem with the community coming in contact with these forms of bacteria.
The West Atlanta Watershed Alliance started as a community effort to stop the placement of a sewer treatment facility.
We actually mobilized with a broad base of citizen groups and other activists to actually stop that placement of that sewer treatment facility in West Atlanta along Utoy Creek. We felt as though there were other options, naturalizing stream channels as opposed to keeping streams and pipes.
The advocacy campaign has evolved into an environmental education outreach organization. Their outdoor activity center sits on a 26-acre nature preserve and acts as the Alliance's headquarters and educational facility.
Kids who don't get a chance to feel that kind of connection to nature can come to our facility right in their own backyards. And then we engage them by taking them to county parks and city parks and to facilitate camping and other recreational activities, off-road cycling, the like. We've taken kids on trips, boat trips up and down to Chattahoochee to show them what their watershed is connected to, because we all share this resource along with other communities up and down to additional states, Alabama and Florida. So we're looking to increase our partnerships up and down by connecting with watershed groups in those other states.
The Belt Line is a green space project circling the city of Atlanta. The West Atlanta Watershed Alliance hopes to connect their urban neighborhood to the system.
Our goal is to have 200 acres of green space that would run along Proctor Creek. And so we feel as though it would be a great west side spur that would link folks back and forth and hopefully take some of the economic development that could occur on the Beltline and move it down. And perhaps we can get workforce development type projects where residents could actually work on. And certainly we hope that it would kind of spur some of the smart growth and green building opportunities that could come as we start to revitalize the neighborhood as well. It's broadening our scope and looking much more at community and economic development, which is a place that we haven't gone yet, but it seems like a natural fit for the work that we're doing.